गुड इवनिंग चिल्ड्रन, गुड इवनिंग चिल्ड्रन. यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट आई गेव वन टेस्ट नो ऑन द एक्सपोनेंट्स एंड पावर्स. वी ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड दिस चैप्टर. दैट्स व्हाई आई गेव वन सिंपल टेस्ट. फॉर दैट दीज आर द सॉल्यूशंस. सी द फर्स्ट वन, ए पावर एम इंटू बी पावर एम इज इक्वल्स टू ए बी होल पावर एम. वी हैव टू यूज दैट फॉर्मुला. नेक्स्ट हियर he asked you to find out in the standard form. That's why we wrote the standard form. Next one also, this is usual form. Next one standard form. Next c power n by d power n. This is also one exponent law. Next this one, for sixth one it is I think anything power 0 is equals to 1. Here seventh one 0, eighth one 1, ninth one n is equals to 4. We have to apply there the formula and then you have to find the answer. A into A into A into A 2174 times. That means A to the power of 2174. Next 3 by 5 whole power minus 1. So that is nothing but we have to reciprocal this numerator to denominator, denominator to numerator. Again he gave whole power minus 1. Again you have to reciprocal, you will get the answer 3 by 5. Next this one 1 by 2 whole cube minus 1 by 2 whole cube. 1 by 2, 1 by 2 into 3 times you have to write. 2 into 2 into 2, 8 minus into minus into minus. Minus into minus plus, plus into minus, minus you will get. Next this one I think 64 you have to do. Next one a power minus 7. Then this one 3 square, 4 square, 4 by 3 whole power minus 2. You have to reciprocal this one and you have to 3 square is nothing but 9, 4 square means 16. 1, this one 8 power 4, 1 by 10 whole cube. 1 by 10 whole cube is nothing but whole cube means 3 times you have to write. 10 into 10 into 10 is nothing but 1000. So next one is 2, 3 power 4 into 4 power 4 is equals to 12 power 4. How? A power m into b power m. A, b, multiply this 2, 3 fourths 12. Whole power m, same powers you have to write. Okay, this is all about yesterday's exams solutions. Today we will see the new chapter, that is rational numbers. Today we will see the new topic, that is first chapter, that is rational numbers. See, even one person also kept the answers, solutions in the group. Just simply you are watching the videos and just you are leaving. Okay, next topic is first chapter, 8th class students. This is first chapter, that is rational numbers. Rational numbers. Before going to this rational numbers, we will have a just look for this introduction. We have a just look on this introduction. See the first one, before going to rational numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on are called, what are those? Counting numbers. Counting numbers are also known as natural numbers. What are those? Natural numbers. Natural numbers. These natural numbers are denoted by capital letter N. Capital letter N. In this natural numbers, which is the smallest number? Smallest natural number is 1. Which is the largest natural number? We can't say, because it is there is no particular number. There is no particular greatest number. This is infinity. We can write infinite number of numbers. That's why we can't say the greatest number. But smallest number we can say, that is 1. If you go to next one, that is whole numbers. What are whole numbers? What are whole numbers? For this natural numbers only, if you add zero to this natural numbers plus zero, we will get the whole numbers. Only zero. The difference between natural numbers and whole numbers is zero only. Only natural, all natural numbers will be there in whole numbers, also zero will be there. So which is the smallest whole number? Zero. what is the highest whole number we can't define. In the same way here also we can't define. It is up to infinite number of numbers we can write. That's why we can't define the highest whole number. See, if you what is the difference between any two successive natural numbers? Difference means subtraction. After subtraction we get the answer, no? That we call it as difference. What is the difference between two natural numbers, successive natural numbers? Is always one. Okay, between these whole numbers also, what is this difference between two successive whole numbers? Is also one only. Okay, next one, this whole numbers plus negative numbers is nothing but -1, -2, -3, -4 and so on are called integers. These whole numbers are denoted by W. These whole numbers are denoted by W and these are the integers. These are integers and these integers are denoted by Z. These integers are denoted by Z. See how to write the integers. See, 0 will be there in between negative numbers. Negative numbers will be there on the left hand side and positive numbers will be there on the right hand side. See, after 0, immediately what you will write? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are all, from here if you see, means these are all whole numbers. What are the negative numbers? How to write negative numbers? -1, -2, -3 and so on. Up to so on we can write it. Up to infinity levels we can write here. Here also we can write the infinity levels. In this, we can give the definition like this. Positive numbers, negative numbers plus 0. We call it as integers. These integers are denoted by Z. See, in these integers, which is the smallest integer? See, in these integers, which is the smallest one? See, -1, these 1 is the smallest. If you go for like this, negative numbers also 0, -1, -2, -3. 0, minus 1 is less than 0. And -2 is less than 0. And -2 is less than -1. That means, if you compare -3 and -1, -3 is the smallest one. In this way, if you go on right and up to infinity we can write, we can't define the smallest integer. We can't define the smallest integer. That too, if you go like this, it is the biggest number, no? Greatest number. We can't define the greatest number also. We can't define smallest integer. We can't define the largest integer. If you go for only positive values, these are the positive values. If you go for the positive values, which is the smallest positive integer? 1. Which is the largest positive integer? We can't define. Why? Because it's, and so on, up to infinity we can write. That's why we can't define. If you go for negative, if you see the negative integers, which is the largest negative integer, means this is the largest negative integer. Which is the smallest negative integer? If you go like this, these are the smallest numbers. So we can't define the smallest integer. That's why in the negative itself, largest we can define. In the positive numbers, we can define only the smallest. We can't define the largest numbers. This is about the integers. Now we'll see the new one, today's topic, that is nothing but rational number. See how to write natural numbers. See, 1, 2, 3, 4 are natural numbers, no? For example, 10. We can write 10 by 1. Or we can write 10 by 2. Or 10 by 2. Or 5. 5. How to write this 5? 2 1s, 2 5s. We can write 5 like this also. 10 by 2. 10 by 2. We can write this 5 in this process also. 10 by 2 is nothing but one numerator, denominator. In fractional form also, if you write, you will get the same answer, that is 5. Whole numbers, for example, 0 by 1 is nothing but, this is fraction form, but actually the value of this one is 0, always 0. 0 by 10, also 0. If you go for negative integer, see, -4 is nothing but -4 by 1 also we can write it. minus 20 is nothing but minus 20 by 1. We can write like this, no? So, for these rational numbers, the rational number should be in the form of P by Q form, where P and Q are integers, maybe minus values or plus values. P by Q, B by Q belongs to integers and Q is not equal to 0. It should not be at any cost. Here it should not come 0. So that those numbers are known as rational numbers. See, natural numbers plus 0, we call it as whole numbers. Natural numbers plus 0, that means whole numbers plus negative numbers, we call it as integers. Natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, all come under these rational numbers. They are in the form of P by Q and Q is not equal to 0 and P, Q, P by P, Q belongs to the integers. These rational numbers are also known as quotient numbers and they are denoted by, rational numbers are denoted by letter Q, okay? Today we saw just the introduction of that rational numbers. Tomorrow we'll see the remaining topic. Thank you.